Today we're looking at free software for making music on your computer quickly and easily. It's Magix Music Maker Free 2019. Welcome to Simple Green Tech, where we do tips, tutorials, and reviews to help you unleash your creativity. I'm Radio Zane, and in this video, we're doing a Magix Music Maker review. We're looking at the Magix Music Maker Free Edition. I haven't downloaded any additional sound pools. This is exactly how it is when you first download it. And speaking of downloads, I put a link to Magix's website in case you want to download it and get started for yourself. But right now, let's jump in. When you first open Magix Music Maker Free, you'll be greeted with this window asking you to activate an edition of Music Maker. If you don't have an edition to activate, you can just click on the X in the corner. And don't worry, if you need to activate a purchased edition later, you can do that. You'll then see this welcome window where you can create a new project, load a project, or load the demo project. We're going to be creating a new project today, but I do encourage you to poke around the demo a little bit just to get an idea of what the possibilities are of this program. And now that we have a project created, we can start to make music. But first, I find the default layout is a little bit congested. You have this keyboard down here and this window over here. To turn either of these off, you go up to the corner and you can click this to turn off the keyboard, and you can click this one to turn off the media pool. I'm going to leave the media pool on, but I'm going to take away the keyboard from the bottom. So let's now look at the media pool area. This is where your sound pools are going to be located. And sound pools are basically full songs that are broken down into individual stems, meaning that these are the instruments and the sections all separated into pieces or loops that you can arrange however you want in the arranger section, which is over here. You can also adjust the pitch of each. There are 7 pitches for each loop, and you can toggle those with these numbers right here. Typically, these go C, D, E, F, G, A, B. But some sound pools might be different. So to just be sure what you're bringing in, you can click on one of these. We'll click on 2, and we'll drag this over into the arranger. And you can see up here, it says it's a D. And you can do that with pretty much all of the loops that are included in the sound pools. And the cool thing is, if you bring another sound pool underneath that, doesn't matter what you clicked on, it's also going to be in D. So let's create a basic 4-bar beat. So I've now created this basic 4-bar pattern here. It has drums, bass, synth, and strings. And it's all being taken out of this sound pool right here, which is the basic one that Magix Music Maker Free comes with. Now, what if we need to adjust the levels a little bit? To do that, we're going to want to bring up the mixer view. You can press M on your keyboard, or you can go up to View, Mix, Mixer. And to adjust the levels, we'll start playback, and then we'll just adjust the sliders for each track. Until we come up with the desired levels that we want. You can also add effects to each track, and to do that, you can either click on the effects button in the mixer view, or if you're in the arranger view, you can click on the effects button right here and go to audio effects rack track. And say we want the compressor. We can turn it on by just clicking on the on button here. Then you can adjust the settings however you like in here. And you have a couple of presets in here that you can choose from. As you can see, there are some other effects like reverb, EQ, and echo that you can enable by default. But you can also bring up other effects down here like distortion, filter, and you even got this cool guitar amp sim. It's called Vandal SE. And you can run this on any track like your drums or whatever you want. Or if you're a guitar player, you can use this as a guitar amp. So if you want to record some guitar right over top of your beats, you would just go to an open track like right here, click on the Rec button, and you want to make sure that it says Audio Recording. So we have it armed now. Then we would just hit the record button, and it will record whatever input you have going in there. There are also a few virtual instruments included in Magic's Music Maker Free. If you click on the Instrument tab here, you'll see that you have these three enabled. And I'm not sure why these other three are here. I do own them as VST plugins, and I guess Magic's Music Maker Free has picked those up too. But you'll just get these three basic ones here. You have Concert Grand LE, which is a piano instrument. You have Revolta, which is a synth instrument. And you have Vita, which is a drum machine. And if you want to use any of these instruments, let's say we want the piano, we can drag it over into a track. And by default, it creates a MIDI pattern here, and it's just a demo pattern. So if you double click on that, you can bring up this piano roll here and you can choose to edit, or you can just click on it, hit the delete key on your keyboard and get rid of it, then start brand new by right clicking, create a new object, and you want to create new MIDI object. You can choose however many bars you want here. You can always extend it later on. Then to edit anything in there, you double click on it. Then you can click on the pencil button up here and start drawing in your notes however you want them. You can add to your collection by buying more instruments from the Magic's Music Maker store. You can see the pricing up here. And you can also add to your sound pool collection by clicking on Store, and you want to see more sound pools here. And you do actually get some more free sound pools included with this. To find those, instead of name, click on that, and you want Price Ascending. And you can see that there's four free sound pools available right here. To download it, you would just click Purchase and then follow the step-by-step instructions. If you just want to jump into a program and start making music with a very little learning curve, and you want all of the tools at your fingertips, Magic's Music Maker Free is a great starting point, and it can grow with you as your needs grow. I'll be adding more videos to this Magic's Music Maker Free Edition series, so if you want to check out the features in more depth, like MIDI recording or audio recording, please be sure to subscribe. And if you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. Thank you so much for watching. For Simple Green Tech, I'm Radio Zane, and we'll talk soon.